Hello and welcome to the MP Tech Group. Back upstairs with Laughing Chris, and back upstairs in the Nerve Center, back upstairs where you do support of all kinds of software and hardware. And you, Chris, spend a lot of your day on Zebra devices, getting them ready for a customer's project or application, supporting customers, all of those things. And so you're intimate with Zebra's version of Android. Right?
Right.
And Zebra's had Android out for 15 years now?
14, I think.
14 years?
At this point, yeah.
And when it first came out, it wasn't baked. It wasn't where it needed to be. You didn't even have, the ability to log on different users. And
right.
You didn't have any Wi-Fi security. You didn't have anything. And so we kind of rebuked it. And at that time, Windows Mobile, Windows CE was still a thing. So we could wait for it to mature. But now it's more than matured. And you said to me the other day, if a customer tried to buy just a consumer device or something and do some of the work that our customers are doing in their warehouses and on their manufacturing floor, it'd be almost impossible to do because of all the tools that Zebra has baked into their version of Android, right?
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of tools that just make everything a lot easier to manage from an enterprise standpoint, or just setting them up. Things that if you went out and bought a consumer device, you're going to have to manually set up every single device. Some of them can't obviously do the things that we're doing on our devices, like who has built-in scanners. People are using cameras instead of the scanners. Cameras are clearly, inferior when it comes to those
types of barcodes. Barcodes, like every minute is part of your job.
Right.
If you're reading a barcode, casual scanning is what Zebra calls
right.
it. Twice a day, I got to read a barcode. Okay, well, use your camera.
Right.
Well, no, I mean, in an hour's time, I read 100 barcodes. Okay, yep. You should probably have
or distance, right? 40 feet,
yeah.
100 feet.
You should have a barcode reader built in the device, yep. And you should have, the first one we're going to talk about is DataWedge, right?
Yeah.
You should have a tool in there that says what symbology barcodes are okay to read. What distance, where in the application do I put the data? Tell me what DataWedge will do.
So DataWedge allows you to manage all scanning, like you said. So either directly to the app, you can manipulate the data. So if you're scanning GS1 codes, you could pull part of the code out. You could put whatever you want in the code, put extensions in it. It allows you to then send it to a specific app or send it to all apps. But what's nice about it is that you're managing it in there. People that are going out and buying, Bluetooth scanners and pairing them to your cell phone or whatever, well, now you have a whole nother app and device to have to go configure that. So this allows you to do everything from the device.
GS1 barcodes, let's go into that for a minute. Because, I got a data identifier, parentheses, two-digit character, I got my part number. And then in the same barcode, another data identifier, parentheses, two-digit, with a serial number, right?
Yep.
So you scan that with your phone, it's just going to give
Send
you that gobbledygook.
Yep.
But with the Zebra device, you could go, hey, take that part number, put it into this field, then take that second part number or that serial number and put it down in this field.
Yeah.
So you could parse all that data, put it into two different fields.
Yeah, you can parse, order it, or delete out what you don't want.
Yeah, even better. Just read the first part, ditch the second part.
Yeah.
I don't care about
that.
Yeah,
because a lot of times you're reading it into like a part number, right? So you might just need the identifier of the item and you don't want the serial number. It's almost always lot number. Like the only time you want the lot number is if you're trying to put lot
right.
In that time.
But if you did want to skip the part number, just input the lot number, you
could
do that with DataWedge. It lets you do all of that.
Yep.
So let's keep rolling. And the device you've got right here is one of Zebra's RFID sleds, mm-hmm. right? With a TC58 on here. Mm-hmm. And it has DataWedge on it. But for this reader, you need 123 RFID, right?
Yeah. 123 RFID is Zebra's quick find of the RFID. So it allows us to connect to an RFID reader and then manage all the configuration. So we can tell it to output in hex. All that data does allow us to scan in any app, right? So now I can open up a web browser and scan RFID into that. Instead of having to write something special.
And, a lot of people know this now. 10 years ago, nobody knew this. But people just think RFID tags work like barcodes. But they don't. Because if you enable this and you got a whole bunch of, you got a 75 reads in a second. It just like blew up in your hand.
Yep.
So 123 RFID would help you manage that data coming in, right?
Yeah, it does allow you to do certain types of things, right? So like if you were reading certain RFID codes and you knew that they started with a certain digit or something, you could hone into just that, right? Or you could lower the power. So instead of reading, you know, a wide area, you can lower it all down.
And only so all the settings of the RFID reader as well.
Are in there,
Cool. I'm trying to remember the number, by the way. There's 13 or 14 applications that Zebra has built in to their Android. So we're not going to touch on all of them, but we're going to highlight a few of them. One of them is StageNow, right? Yep. And so there's not a StageNow application on the device per se, or is there?
Yeah, so this application on the device is just a receiving.
Okay.
You're thinking of on the PC, there's a StageNow application that allows you to configure all the settings, apps, anything you really want to put on the device or control on the device into a barcode. And then on the device, you just open up StageNow, you scan the barcode, and then it takes all those configurations and puts them on the device.
So we use it to remote support customers. Hey, I'm having a problem. I see you guys do that on the support line. Hey, I can't read this barcode. Oh, that's a weird barcode. We need to turn it on the reader. Here's a, you know, scan the StageNow barcode. It'll activate that barcode in the reader for you.
Yeah, you can use it for a lot of different reasons. One would be to change DataWedge even. You could, customer was saying they were having problems with their DataWedge, you could go in and set up a DataWedge profile and then send it down through StageNow and then change the barcode reader. We use it a lot for installing applications. MDMs.
Yeah, and so I kind of jumped ahead because it's the customer already has it and is using it and needs to tweak something. But the big time we use StageNow is, A, I got brand new devices, and we'll bring hundreds of them in down here, and you guys will get the customer's applications on it, get their wireless settings on there, get their OS updated to the latest. You'll do all of that in-house, you know, kind of pre-configuring the devices for the customer, and you'll use StageNow here to do that, right?
We use that on a daily basis.
Yeah. Here's another thing. The customer always forgets this. I got it all set up. It's all going. Oh, one broke. I got to send it back to Zebra for repair. Well, when it comes back from Zebra, it's wiped.
Yeah.
So, you know, the customer could, I've seen customers with StageNow barcodes just kind of taped right here because when it comes back from repair, bip, scan it. Okay, here, it's ready to go.
Yeah, we see that a lot, especially our customers or even us. We have binders full of barcodes for specific customers. Yeah.
Here's another one, enterprise browser, right? So Zebra's browser. And we see this with customers. They're like, well, I'm running it in Chrome, but it's doing, you know, it's number one, I unlocked Chrome. Now the users are doing all kinds of things I don't want them to do. That barcode data, I want it to go in a certain field. So tell me what people would use Enterprise Browser for.
Yeah, so Enterprise Browser is used mostly from getting away from Chrome. So typically we use it, you lock down the browser. So essentially now you're only able to get to whatever websites that you want them to get to. Even if there's multi-sites, you can add them all in. You can control the scanner. You can control sound. So if you actually design your website to run it, you could have it beep a specific way for a specific type of scan or anything. You can also manipulate the website. So you can put intents in there. Let's say your website wasn't built for mobile, which we see quite a bit. You can go in and kind of modify the website to try to fit the mobile device.
Oh, nice.
And like you hinted on, Chrome is not lockable. So there is no way to prevent them from being able to have a full experience because it's a public web browser. And that can cause problems. Even if they are not trying to cause problems, what if they accidentally click on the favorites or they click on the browser bar or something? Like, there's lots of different things in that can, you know.
Get them in trouble.
Yeah, or just steer you away from doing your job.
Yeah, cool. So. All right, what am I missing?
One of the newer ones is OEMConfig. So this is actually configuring the back end of the OS. So a full enterprise OS that you want to add different configurations or runs, maybe modify how the scanner acts or something like that, or specific apps, you can then push through a config and then change those settings on the fly to the device.
Cool.
And then RxLogger. RxLogger is probably one of the most important ones for an enterprise, is because it will allow you to take a log from the device and it pulls everything. So if you're having any type of issue, whether it's network or an app's crashing or anything really, visually even, you run RxLogger, you have the issue, you stop RxLogger, and then once you stop it, you can send that file. We do a lot of pre-testing, but if you send that file to Zebra, they'll go through full cat logs and everything. So processor level testing.
And if you're on the on a session with Zebra and you're trying to solve a problem with their support, they may tell you to start that. When the problem hits, stop it, send us that file.
Yeah, the two first things that we typically hear from Zebra support is, what OS is it on? And typically they're wanting us to put it on the latest OS, and then have you ran RxLogger and test it.
Yeah, nice.
But something that we normally do anyways. And then they also have another one is the wireless analyzer. You can actually turn this on and walk around, and it gives you live feedback of the Wi-Fi. So if you have the device in hand and you're testing one device, you can do that. And then the Zebra
poor man's wireless site survey.
It is 100% that.
Yeah, nice.
And then typically you have your Zebra Bluetooth capability. So they pull their own Bluetooth stack so that it's a little bit easier to manage what devices you're attaching to. But only not just that, if you did have a Bluetooth scanner or something like that, or this sled obviously comes in Bluetooth.
Yeah.
You can then connect to it by tapping to it.
Yeah. Okay, we could go on all day. You got anything else that's a must tell? Probably about it.
That's about it off the top of my head.
You'll think of one after
there's always something. Yeah.
Okay, the point made, and that is that Zebra over the past 14 years has really baked Android. And my favorite part of this is some of the early things Zebra was doing with Android to make it more enterprise ready. Well, Google just copied it and added to Android themselves, right?
So,
people want to use Apple products in their environment because people like Apple products, but there's so many down pitfalls to that Zebra with Android is overcome and made it an enterprise grade product to be used by someone for their job. Not sitting at home playing solitaire like I do.
Yeah. I mean, using an enterprise level device over a consumer device, no matter what the OS is, has a lot of benefits, especially when you're managing multiple devices.
Cool. Beautiful. Well, if you want this level of expertise, somebody who's got the immediate answers, I sit on the support email string and I'm blown away sometimes by the answers you guys give just right off the top of your head. And I'll see you driving and the customer is looking at their screen trying to fit, and you've got it all in your head. You can answer them while you're driving down the road. So it's just amazing levels of expertise that we have here. So best place to reach us, emptechgroup.com. Thanks for watching.